Today, we are going to talk about a fascinating concept called Byzantine Fault Tolerance or BFT. It's a critical aspect of distributed systems that ensures they can handle faults, including the malicious nodes. Now, before we dive into BFT, let's talk about distributed systems. A distributed system is a collection of independent computers that work together to achieve a common goal. In contrast to a single computer, a distributed system can handle more significant workloads and provide redundancy and fault tolerance feature. However, distributed systems pose unique challenges, including how to ensure that all nodes agree on the same result. This is where Byzantine fault tolerance comes in. The classic Byzantine general problem is a thought experiment that illustrates the challenge of achieving consensus in a distributed system. The problem is as follows. Imagine a group of Byzantine generals who are planning to attack a city. The generals are located at different parts of the city and must communicate with each other to agree on a strategy. However, some of the generals may be traitors who want to sabotage the plan. The problem is, how can loyal generals agree on a plan that is resilient to the traitor's attempt to disrupt the process? In essence, the Byzantine generals problem demonstrates the challenge of achieving consensus in a distributed system, especially when some nodes are malicious or faulty. So, that's the problem. Now, what about the solution? Well, one solution to Byzantine generals problem is practical Byzantine fault tolerance or PBFT. In a nutshell, PBFT is an algorithm that ensures a group of computers can agree on something even if some of them are trying to cheat or disrupt the process. Wondering how it works? Let me share it with you how. So, PBFT works by using a replicated state machine approach. Each node has a copy of the same state machine and runs the same set of instructions. When a new value needs to be agreed upon, a node proposes a value and other nodes replicate the state machine by running the same instructions on their copy. However, before the decision is made, a multi-step voting process takes place to ensure the majority of nodes agree on the value. In the first step, the proposer sends a message to all other nodes with their proposed value. In the second step, all nodes receive the proposal and reply to the message indicating whether they are agreeing or not. Once the proposer receives the sufficient number of votes, the value is accepted and the state machine is updated with the new value. The process is repeated for each new value that needs to be agreed upon. So, PBFT ensures that a decision is made only when a majority of nodes agree on it and that this decision is final and cannot be changed. If a node behaves maliciously, the other nodes can detect this and exclude the dishonest node from the consensus process. And although PBFT is a promising solution, it does have a few drawbacks. One is that it requires a relatively large number of nodes to operate efficiently. Also, PBFT assumes that nodes are not only Byzantine fault tolerant, but also self-verifying, which means they can detect if they have been hacked and reported to the other nodes. And if you think practically, this can be difficult to achieve in the real-world scenario. Further, another solution to Byzantine generals problem is Federated Byzantine Agreement or FBA. So, FBA is a consensus algorithm that is used in blockchain technology and is designed to be more efficient than PBFT. In FBA, nodes are grouped into federations and each federation has its consensus algorithm. Nodes vote for other nodes to become validators in the federation, and once a sufficient number of votes have been casted, the validator is added to the federation. The validator then participates in the consensus process and agrees on the new value. Now, if we compare the two, then easily one can say that FBA is more efficient than PBFT because it allows for more flexible participation in the consensus process and nodes can join or leave a federation at any time. And there can be many federations running in parallel as well. And inherently, one of the main benefits of FBA is that it's scalable, which means it can handle a large number of nodes without sacrificing over performance. That's also the reason why FBA is used in several blockchain projects, including the Stellar Network, which is also known for its fast and low-cost transactions. However, FBA also has its limitations. One is that it's not as fault-tolerant as PBFT because it relies on the assumption that most nodes are honest. And here, if a federation is controlled by a malicious node, they can manipulate the consensus process and undermine the security of the network. To summarize, Byzantine fault tolerance is a key concept in ensuring the reliability and security of a distributed system. PBFT and FBA are two possible solutions to the Byzantine Generals problem with their own advantages and drawbacks. In a nutshell, PBFT is more fault tolerant but requires a larger number of nodes, while FBA is more efficient but relies on trust between federations. Also, PBFT is an algorithm that ensures consensus is reached only when a majority of nodes agree, and it assumes that nodes are Byzantine fault tolerant and self-verifying. FBA, on the other hand, is a consensus algorithm that groups nodes into federations and allows for more flexible participation in the consensus process. It's scalable but less fault tolerant than PBFT. Both PBFT and FBA have their pros and cons, and their suitability depends on the specific requirements of the distributed system. However, we should equally account for the fact that they are critical tools for ensuring the security and reliability of distributed systems in a world where malicious actors are increasingly common. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you like my content, feel free to smash that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.